Testing 1, 2. Test. Check. Testing 1. Testing 1, 2. Check. Testing 1, 2. Check. Testing 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. Testing 1, 2, 1, 2. Check. Testing 1, 2. One, two, check. Testing 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Testing 1, 2. Test, test. Check, testing 1, 2, 3. You twist the input. Cause the left, right not balanced also. Testing 1, 2. No, but here going out is left, right, so you twist and see. Testing 1, 2. Left, right, where got balance? One higher than the other side. Oh, okay.
Yahweh, Yahweh, holy Good morning, Glad Tidings Slang. Happy Chinese New Year. Can I just invite all of us to stand to our feet? And why not, as we do this, let's go around, again, wish five people a happy Chinese New Year, right? Go around, don't just wish your own family members. Go around, shake someone's hand. Okay, Pastor Gideon need to have more because he's a pastor, so you need to have at least 10, Pastor Gideon. Alright, while we are also moving around and greeting one another, can I also just invite us to come to the front a little bit since we're moving around? There's a lot of space in the front here, there's a lot of seats. So can I invite all of us just to come to the front as well? Come closer to the front, take a few seats in front. So before we go into worship today, I just felt, you know, as I was driving to church this morning, you know, Chinese New Year is a really, honestly, it's a very loud time, right? It's a very loud time. Like, how many of us got more than 5 hours of sleep on the first day? It was so loud. Honestly, I'm usually one that can sleep through fireworks, but this year, I think everyone just wanted to go all out, okay? But yes, Chinese New Year is a time to be... It's very loud, you know. I think us, coming from Klang, Hokkien family as well, we're also known to be a bit louder. But I think during this time, as I was doing my devotions yesterday, I was going through the book of Acts, and I was at Acts 4. And we always say, I think, even before Chinese New Year, that Chinese New Year as well is an opportunity to share the gospel with people. You know, many of them know you as Christians, know your faith, and sometimes as well, like for myself as well, many of them were, me coming into church, they were asked about, oh, how's things working in church, and asked about why I'm going into church. And that's actually a really great opportunity for me to just share a little bit about my convictions, about the gospel as well. So yes, yesterday as I was doing devotion, I was reading through the book of Acts, and towards verse 23, the title of that section was "The Believers Prayed for Boldness." And that really encouraged me to say as well, like during this time when Chinese New Year is loud, that we also can be bold to share the gospel with people. That we can be bold because this is a time reunion, right? Reunion dinner, reunion meals. We are meeting all our family members. And I know deep down, all of us, we love our family members. And we want to see them, those who do not know Christ, to know Him, right? That's one of our prayers. I'm sure many of us, we have brothers, sisters, uncles, aunties that we have been praying for. Like we've seen them, we told them about God before, they maybe have come to church before, but they still haven't committed their life to Christ. I just want to encourage, because I feel as I was driving to church today that some of us have that desire as well, have that desire to see so many of our loved ones come to Christ. So can I just encourage us before we worship, before we praise God for how good He is, let's take this 1 to 2 minutes. If you're with your family, if you are with your spouse, I can invite you to gather together, and if you're with your friends, also to gather together and start praying. Start praying, because I'm sure many of us will be going for our Chinese New Year lunch later and meeting our family. Start praying in this 1 or 2 minutes for boldness. For boldness. Yes, for we trust in God, but that's also 100% is God, trusting in God, and 100% as well is our responsibility to share the gospel, right? So let me encourage you guys. And I'm also going to pray this. For boldness. For boldness to share Jesus with our family. For boldness to share Jesus with our friends. And for boldness as well, that when, you know, they might ask us so many different questions, for boldness to stand up for Christ. Boldness to stand up for God. So can I just invite you in this time, with your family, with your spouse, to pray. To pray for boldness. Lord, we declare, God, that you are a sovereign Lord, that you are God over everything. And Lord, you are even Lord over this festive season right now. Lord, even though we may be focused on all the different things that Chinese New Year we celebrate, Lord, but Lord, we recognize, God, that at the end of the day, that you are King. That you are King, Lord. And Lord, I just pray, God, as we, as your followers, as your disciples, have this amazing opportunity once or twice a year to share the gospel with our family members. Lord, I pray for boldness, Lord. Lord, that you will make us bold, Lord. Lord, like just as the disciples were in Acts, as Lord, as they pray for boldness, oh God, that you begin to shake the ground, Lord. And Lord, I just pray, oh God, that you begin to shake the foundations as well, oh God, as we share, oh God, the gospel, Lord, that Lord, I pray, oh God, for strongholds to be broken, Lord. I pray, oh God, for walls to collapse, oh God, and that they will be, their hearts will be open, oh God, to hearing about you, oh Lord. That even in Chinese New Year, though, we may say Christmas and Easter is the season to share the gospel, Lord, but during this Chinese New Year, Lord, that we will see salvation, oh Lord. That we will see salvation among our family members. That we will see salvation among our friends. That we will see salvation among our loved ones, oh Lord. Lord, I pray, oh God, that you begin, oh God, to drop a name into our hearts, Lord. Drop a name into our hearts, Lord, that we may be bold, oh God, to share. That we may be bold, oh God, to share the gospel, oh God, in a time, oh God, that many are focusing on money, many are focusing on every other thing, oh God, but you. But Lord, I just pray, oh God, that you keep our focus on you, oh Lord, during this season, oh God. Let us remember, oh God, that we have a mission, that we have a great commission, oh Lord. And that is to make your name known, oh God, and to make disciples of all nations. So Lord, I just pray, oh God, as we worship you today, oh God, let that boldness, oh God, build in us. Let that boldness build in us, oh God, that we will be bold for you, oh God. So God, I commit the rest of the time into your hands, Lord. May you be lifted high here today, oh God. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Amen. Good morning, church. Are you all ready to give God our highest praise this morning? All right. Come on, let's clap.
Water you turn into wine, open the eyes of the blind, there's no one like you. None like you. Into the darkness you shine, out of the ashes we rise, there's no one like you. None like you. Sing our God. And our God is greater, our God is stronger. God, you are higher than any other. Our God is healer, awesome in power. Our God,
and into the darkness.
And into the darkness you shine. Out of the ashes we rise. There's no one like you. None like you. Sing our God. Our God is greater. Our God is stronger. God, you are higher than any other. Our God is healer, awesome in power. Our God, our God is greater. Our God is stronger. God, you are higher than any other. Our God is healer, awesome in power. Our God, oh.
Let's sing. And if our God, and if our God is for us, then who could ever stop us? And if our God is with us, then what could stand against? And if our God is for us, then who could ever stop us? And if our God is with us, then what could stand against? And what could stand against? God. Our God is greater, our God is stronger. God, you are higher than any other. Our God is healer, awesome in power. Our God, our God is greater, our God is stronger. God, you are higher than any other. Our God is healer, awesome in power. Our God, and if our God is for us, then who could ever stop us? And if our God is with us, then what could stand against? And if our God is for us, then who could ever stop us? And if our God is with us, then what could stand against? And if our God is for us, then who could ever stop us? And if our God is with us, then what could stand against? And if our God is for us, then who could ever stop us? And if our God is with us, then what could stand against? Then what could stand against?
There is a King the scars of healing, there is a Son who came in grace and truth. How great the love that carries us to kindness. Wonderful, you're wonderful.
Church, let's just take this time to linger in His presence and to just worship Him in our own personal ways. Let's not be distracted by other things, but let's just cast our entire attention onto Him and Him alone, and let's just believe and let's just be still in His presence. Just worship Him and exalt Him high and believe that He will always be in control in all of our lives. And hide me now. Hide me.
under your wing. Cover me within your mind. When the oceans rise and thunders roar, I will soar with you above the storm. Father, you are king over the flood. I will be still, know you are God. Find rest, my soul. In Christ alone, know His power in quietness and trust. When the oceans rise and thunders roar, and I will soar with you above the storm. And Father, you are king over the flood, and I will be still and know you are God. When oceans rise and thunders roar, I will soar with you above the storm. Father, you are king over the flood, and I will be still and know you are God. And I will be still and know you are God. In Christ alone, cornerstone, weak made strong, in the Savior's love, through the storm. He is Lord, Lord of all. It's in Christ alone. Christ alone, cornerstone, weak made strong, in the Savior's love. Shall come with trumpet sound. Oh, may I then in Him be found, just in His righteousness alone, faultless stand before the throne. Christ alone,
Christ alone, cornerstone, weak made strong, in the Savior's love, through the storm, He is Lord, Lord of all.
Sing one more time.
Christ alone.
Lord, when the world rejected you, O Lord. O God, that you had a greater plan, O Lord. So Lord, even as we worship you today, O God, in our giving, in our worship, in our with our whole lives, Lord. Lord, may we remember, O God, that everything that we have is because of you, O Lord. That you are our foundation, Lord. Oh, Lord, right now, God, even as we go into the time, oh God, of giving you, oh God, offering, oh God, Lord, I just pray, oh God, that as we give, oh God, during this period, oh God, this season, oh Lord, that we remember, oh God, everything that we have is because of you, oh Lord. And Lord, as we give, oh God, in our offering, oh God, today, oh God, Lord, may we remember, oh God, that we are putting, oh God, and investing, oh God, into your kingdom, oh God. Investing, oh God, for the furtherance of the gospel, oh Lord. So God, I just pray, oh God, as we give today, oh Lord, with our money, oh God, with our monetary, oh God, I just pray, oh God, that you bless every cheerful giver, oh Lord. So God, I just thank you for everything. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Thank you, church. We may take a seat. So right now we are going to time of offering. There's two ways you can give. There's a QR code that you can scan. Or if we also have ushers, can I get the ushers to stand by right now with the offering bag and pass around the offering? So as we, I'll give you guys a little bit of time to give, especially for the offering bag to be passed around. All right, good morning, everybody. Happy Chinese New Year. Thanks. Okay, happy Chinese New Year, everyone. So right now we're just going to go into the time of announcements. First up, first-time visitors. Do we have any first-time visitors with us here today? Anyone? Can raise your hand? Right here, I have this contact card. Can we also invite Ms. Bilin and Adam? Can I just invite you guys to raise your hand? Just so we know, yeah, it's over there. So those around them, can you just welcome them? So glad you can join us today, this Chinese New Year, to join us. Also, we have Pastor Peter and Sister Puewa visiting us again. Can welcome them. So glad to have all of us come back here. Really, it's reunion, right? All right, so let's go into announcements. First up, before we go into that, I just want to also thank everyone on behalf of the church as well. During this Chinese New Year, we had a lot of, if you guys remember, past 2-3 weeks, we had a lot of blessed events, right? We had Blessed Wen Chao, Blessed Disciple House, and Blessed to be a Blessing. A lot of blessings, all right? We just want to commend the church, want to thank the church as well, because all of us gave so generously, and because of that, all these events were so successful. Many of them enjoyed the events, us as well, going there as well. All of us enjoyed. So thank you, church, for your giving as well. So let's go into the announcements. First one, we have prayer meeting, all right? So we just want to highly encourage everyone as well. Prayer meeting is going to happen every Tuesday, okay? It's going to happen every Tuesday at 8 p.m. at the Connect Cafe. And I just want to encourage everyone, this whole church, you know, prayer is such an important aspect of the church. A lot of people say prayer is the engine of the church as well. And I really do believe that because, you know, without prayer, we cannot move forward. Without prayer, we are not in line with God, you know? So it's very important to have your own personal prayer life, but it's also very important to have corporate prayer as well, coming together, united as a church to pray for the direction, to intercede on the behalf of others. And we know many of us are, it's kind of like a sick season as well. A lot of us are falling sick, and during this in prayer meeting, we as well pray for those who are sick, and as well, we of course do our visitations as well after that. But prayer is something that's so important. So I want to invite everyone every Tuesday, 8 p.m. It's going to be at the Connect Cafe, okay? This year we changed up. Last time for, you know, how many years we had it at MPH. This year we wanted a change of atmosphere. We're having it at the Connect Cafe. And I can give a testimony to that. You know, every time we come together and pray, I'm there every week. It's really great. It's a really great time. So yes, do come for prayer meeting. Next announcement. Fundamental Truths. All right, this is our second announcement. Last week we announced this as well. So this is a class. Us as the Assemblies of God Church, we have, the Assemblies of God has 16 fundamental truths. So if you want to know your faith better, you want to know it stronger, or maybe you've already attended a fundamental truth class before and you want a refresher of maybe suddenly in this season you're like, oh, I'm so interested in end times. What do we believe as an AOG church about end times? Or what do we believe about tongues? Or all these different things that we're like, oh, why nobody telling me answers? Actually, a lot of these things you can learn from our 16 fundamental truths. So highly encourage you, especially if you just joined our church maybe in the past 2-3 years, you have not attended this class, this is a really good opportunity to actually understand who we are, kind of our identity as well. So sign up for this class. It's going to start on Sundays, 3rd March to 26th May. It will be happening at 8:45 a.m. to about 9:45 at MPR1, which is behind over here. So if you're interested, do scan the QR code and sign up. All right, that's all the announcements, but we also have, also want to say as well, Royal Rangers, we still have the Outpost Camp and Rangers Kids Outing still available to register. So I want to encourage everyone as well. If you've been thinking about it, you know, you've had a niece or nephew in mind, do ask them, and I highly encourage you guys to sign up. You can you can talk to and connect with any of our Royal Rangers commanders to get more information. But yes, we highly encourage you guys to also sign up for that. Sign up for the kids. It's going to be a great time. I'll be there for the Outpost. I don't know if I want to go to the zoo yet, but like, but I encourage you. Want to see panda, want to see tiger? Yes, can go zoo, okay? So yeah, I think that's all the announcements I have for today. And can we now just give a warm welcome to Pastor Gideon.
Good morning. Good morning, church. It's so nice to see all of us here. You all look so red. It's again really nice to see you. Nice to see Pastor Peter and his wife, Sister Pui Hua. Yeah. And of course, we have some guests with us in our midst, Luke and Caroline. I have also my brother from Singapore. Of course, my nephews, they are also here. Yeah, so they are back for the Chinese New Year, and we're just having a great time of fellowship and bonding. Just in case, I know Gerald said that he won't be there for the zoo, right? But I will be there. So I'll be there in the zoo, and I hope so. I think, I will be there. My wife has told me, say that, let's go to the zoo, you know. We have not been to the zoo for a very long time. How many of you been to our zoo, Negara? Okay, in the last year. Okay, less hands. In the last 2 years? Okay, anyway, I want to encourage you, come and support our zoo, come and fellowship with us, especially the children, right? We are taking the younger ages, children, with us for this outing. And then, of course, we have our Outpost Camp. I will also be there for our Outpost Camp. I will be preaching for one of their night services. I want to really encourage you, parents, if you have children, you want them to just have a little bit of experience, to experience the outdoor, to experience a campfire. This is the place to send them, okay? So encourage you to do so. Okay. I was wondering what to preach this Sunday, you know? Seeing that it is a Chinese New Year, that this Sunday falls on the second day of CNY, I've decided to share a little bit about you know, about some things that you know, that we see around us during Chinese New Year, and more importantly, how we as a Christian should respond. Okay, should respond. I was approached by someone, you know, who actually approached in a sense that they WhatsApped me and they asked me this question. They said, "Pastor, this year is the year of the dragon." Yeah, so as you can see, I forgot to wear my dragon shirt. Oh, no, I don't have lah. But he says, "This year is the year of a dragon." And then he says, "Pastor, how you know, this year all the banks, you know, they are giving out the ang pao, and all the ang pao got dragons on it." And so he asked me, "Pastor, can we use the ang pao or not? And we as Christians, can we use the ang pao or not?" And so I thought to myself, you know, how to answer this person. What do you think? Do you think we as a Christian should be okay for us to use an ang pao with a dragon on it? What do you think? Okay, anyway, hang on. Keep that thought in your mind, because I'm going to come back to it at the end of my sermon, all right? And then we will see, okay? Then we will see. Now, I want to start off by saying this. Of course, the symbols, the traditions, and the festivals of the Chinese New Year are really deeply rooted in more than 5,000 years of history, okay? So it's not just something that is new, but rooted in a 5,000 year of history that involves our culture, our traditions, and more importantly, some of the Chinese beliefs. But I would like to say here, unfortunately, some of our Chinese New Year celebrations have focused too much on our temporal, earthly life, and too much on tangible success. So, if you don't already notice, everything about the Chinese New Year is about prosperity. Even the way we greet people, it is done in that way. And, you know, sometimes if we are not careful, you know, as Christians, we can just follow the crowd and we can just flow along. And so that's why the purpose for me this morning is this, that you know, that I hope that I will be able to share with you, and that you will be able to come for yourself a conclusion on where we stand on some of these matters, because it's important. I've read a quote that says this: if we don't stand for anything, we will fall for everything. All right, let me repeat it: if we don't stand for something, then we will fall for everything. And so I feel it is important that we as Christians be able to give a good, can I use the word, a good response or a good witness in regards to the Chinese New Year. So this morning, you know, I've entitled my message or my sermon, "The Christian Chinese and the Chinese New Year." All right? Now, it doesn't mean that because I use the word "the Christian Chinese," for the rest of us here who are not Chinese, this sermon is not for you. Noah. You can actually substitute your ethnicity there, and you know, and the principles that I'm going to share this morning is for all of us. And so this morning I want to just entitle my sermon, "The Christian Chinese and the Chinese New Year." Now, mind you, I want to just point this one out to you. I've used the term Christian Chinese. I've used the term Christian Chinese instead of a Chinese Christian. Now, why did I do that? This is on purpose. Why did I do that? Well, I did that because I want to be very clear to all of us here this morning that we are first and foremost a Christian. Amen? Then only are we the rest of the thing. You can fill in the blanks. Then Chinese, you're Indian, you're, you know. Then our culture comes in. Then our tradition comes in. So we are first and foremost a Christian. What it also means is that our beliefs, our conviction, must be the underlying factor where we make decisions. So we do not make decisions as a Chinese Christian. We make decisions as a Christian Chinese. It goes on to also to say that you are first a Christian teacher, then a teacher Christian. You are first a Christian businessman, rather a businessman who is a Christian. Why? Because it's very important that we be very clear this morning that our Christian beliefs and principles and must line up with not only the Word of God, but it must be in what we do and what we say. What we say must line up with what we do. So that's why I've entitled this morning, The Christian Chinese and the Chinese New Year. Now, I've noticed in my years as a Christian, there are a few pitfalls that sometimes, you know, we inadvertently, you know, we somehow, you know, not say fall into, but somehow we come into a place of compromise. And this, it is my hope again this morning that I, even as I point this out for us, I'm not here to condemn anyone. I'm not here to scold anyone. But what I want to do is I hope that I'll be able to show us this morning from Scripture, and as the Holy Spirit convicts us, we make the necessary change that is needed. Amen? Amen? Because that's what the Word of God must do. In the Word of God must always confront us. We like it when the Word of God encourages us. We like it when the Word of God, you know, blesses us. But we must never forget the Word of God has another part, which is when it confronts us. It confronts us of sin. It confronts us of where we have gone wrong. It confronts us where we need to make a correction. And so that is my desire this morning. The first thing I want to talk about is about the Chinese zodiac calendar. The Chinese zodiac calendar. In Isaiah, hang on. If you can turn with me into the book of Isaiah, I want to just read verse 47. Verse 47. I want to start from verse 12, and then that will be my background, even as I just share a little bit about the Chinese zodiac calendar. Verse 12 says this, keep on then with your magic spells and with your many sorceries which you have labored at since childhood. Perhaps you will succeed, perhaps you will cause terror. Verse 13 says, all the counsels you have received has only worn you out. Let your astrologers come forward, those stargazers, those who look at the stars and make predictions, who month by month, let them save you from what is coming upon you. Surely they are like stubble, the fire will burn them up. They cannot even save themselves from the power of the flame. These are not coals for warmth, but this is not a fire to sit by. Verse 15 says, that is all they are to you. You have dealt with and labored with since childhood. All of them go in their error. So the Bible tells us, he says, in Isaiah, says, what good is all these things? You have trusted in them, you have used them since young, but what have they caused you? They have not helped you at all. They have not come to your rescue at all. Instead, they have worn you out. And now, the Chinese zodiac calendar, we all are aware of. You know, with the Chinese zodiac calendar, it comes in a cycle of 12, right? Like our 12 months. And so, it is named, and we all know it's named after, you know, the animals. Traditionally, you know, the Chinese dating methods are like I said, you know, in a cycle. And there's an animal that is assigned according to the repeating cycle. You got your rat, you got your ox, you got your tiger, rabbit, dragon. And so happened this year is a year of a dragon. And to the Chinese, they believe that it is an auspicious year. So, you know, it's and you will notice that more children, more Chinese children, abhorrent in this particular year, because why everybody wants to have a dragon baby. But this should not be a considering factor for us as a Christian. The Bible says these are superstitious beliefs, and the Bible has warned us that we should not follow after them. You know, when we look at all these things, you know, according to the Chinese, they believe that the animal ruling the person's birth year will exercise a profound influence on the life of the person. Horoscopes have been developed around the animal signs. And you know, you can see a monthly horoscope, daily horoscope. You know, and you know, for example, you know, the Chinese horoscope might predict this. Is there a person born in the year of the dragon, you know, would be fierce, strong, powerful. And you know, there's all these things that's being associated with the animal. But we have read just from scripture that we are not to follow all these things. You know, friends, there was a time in my life, and if you know my testimony, I was far away from God. And because that I did not have, high education, I had my Form 5, and even in the Form 5, I only passed with a grade 3. And in my SPM, when I came out to work, it was the time when our nation was coming out from the first recession. Jobs were tough to get by, so I took whatever job that I could. And because of that, I always have this inferiority complex. Because I didn't study well, I did not get a good result, I did not have that kind of background, you know. I didn't get to study, go to college or go to university. And because of that, I had this inferiority complex. And that complex caused me to always wonder how I would turn out, how my future would be, whether would I be rich, whether would I be successful. And instead of trusting God for all these things, I had in one point of my life consulted some of these things which the Bible says I should not have done. And I want to say this morning, I'm not proud of them. But I'm sharing because I hope that we all can learn from here. You know, I got mixed up with the wrong crowd of people. And you know, for Chinese New Year, you know what they would do? You know, on the first day after doing all our visitations, we will make a trip to Taiping. And on one of the very obscure hill, there is a small temple. Nobody knows this temple, but you know what? There will always be a throng. It's so secluded, but there will always be a throng of people going there on a Chinese New Year. And these people brought me there, and you know, we consulted mediums, and I wanted to know my future. I wanted to know whether I'll be rich. How many of you don't want to be rich? I don't think there's anything wrong in being rich, but I want you just to be very clear that our mind must never be always preoccupied with making money. If everything you think about is about making money, then I think, friends, we have to make some adjustments here. And I would go for all this because why? I wanted to know my future. And these people, these mediums, they could tell me to a certain extent. Before my day started, you know, every day, you know, last time when we used to have newspapers, how many of you know what a newspaper looked like? You know, in the newspaper column, I want you to know that it is no coincidence that they put the horoscope next to the comics. So when you read the comics, right, it's lighthearted, it's fun. And so by way of that, you look at your horoscope. Oh, I'm a... What's the horoscope? I so forgot already. Oh, okay. And you need prayer, brother. You know, I will read it And then, you know, but I in my mind, I said, not really. I don't really believe lah and all. But the fact is this, as you keep reading all these things, it becomes an addiction. So you don't start your day without reading that. It becomes a habit. And then sooner or later, what happens is that this habit becomes something that has a hole in your life. And you read it. Instead of reading your Bible, you are reading all these things. And so, friends, for us as a Christian Chinese, we don't believe, can I just categorically say this, that we do not believe in the Chinese zodiac. I shared this before. You know, one day my children, because of they go to a Chinese school, right? So they come back and they were talking. And you know, one of my children says, you know what? I'm born in the year of the monkey. And then going around running like a monkey, you know. And I had to stop that. I had to stop and I have to talk to them. I call all of them and I told them, I says, no, you are not born in the year of a monkey, and you should not behave like a monkey, because the Bible tells us very clearly that we are all made in the image of God. So you're not born in the year of a dragon. You're born in the year of our Lord and of our Lord, our Savior, who we are made in His image. The Bible makes it very clear. We are the children of God. You don't belong to some animal. And neither should, because you think that, you know, you are born under that particular zodiac sign, therefore, your life is somehow influenced by that. You know, like I said, there was one time in my life, you know, that I was so influenced by this, it was terrible. You know, I was born in the year of a dog. I'm saying this just as an example. You know, one of my relatives used to tell me, "Oh, when were you born? Were you born in the daytime or were you born in the nighttime?" So I says, "What's the difference?" He says, "You know what? Born in the daytime, that means you as a dog, you'll be sleeping, so you have a good life. If you're born during the nighttime, the dog is supposed to look after the house. You're supposed to jaga the house, right? So you have a hard life." And all these things, friends, I want to tell you, is a load of... But the problem is, we buy into this. Even though we say, I don't believe, lah, but you know what? Sometimes a lie told very often becomes somewhat truth to you. And we have to be very careful, because the Bible makes it very clear, all those who practice all these things, divination, all those who practice all these things, you know, we don't consult feng shui master. Hello? Some of those things that the feng shui master talk about are practical things. You can look at it and you can think for yourself. Practical things. Oh, they'll tell you, oh, no good, your house, in front of your house, there's a big tree. The tree blocks all your good luck, you know. But you, practically, you look at it, of course, no good to have a big tree, because you know why? What happens if the tree falls down and it hits your house? That's practical. That's common sense. So you don't need to go, and please, I pray that we as Christians, we don't practice this, we don't buy into this. Some of the things that are being said, you know, like I said, in feng shui, it's common sense. If you need help, come and see your pastors. Not that we are in the building or construction business or whatever, but you know what? I think we have enough people here in our church who can help you, who can talk common sense. So the Bible makes it very clear that we know we don't consult all these things. In the book of Deuteronomy, you don't have to turn to don't have to turn to it, but in Deuteronomy 18, chapter 18, it says this, verse 9 to 14. It says, when you enter the land of the Lord your God is giving to you, do not learn to imitate the detestable ways of the nation there. Let no one be found among you who sacrifices their son or daughter in the fire, who practices divination or sorcery, interpret omens, engages in witchcraft, or casts spells, or who is a medium or spiritist, or who consults the dead. It's the Bible. Anyone who does these things is the word that is used there, detestable. Detestable to the Lord. Because of these some detestable practices, the Lord your God will drive out those nations before you. You must be, the verse 13 says this, you must be blameless before your Lord your God. Now, I suspect the older generation have no issue with some of these things, but you know, the younger generation, when the lines are so blurred that we don't see some of these things and we are not careful. So, friends, we need to look at this and we have to be careful. And I want to just say this morning, that we are never born in the year of the dragon. But rather, as Psalms 139, verse 14 says, I praise you because I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Your works are wonderful. I know that full well. I know it so well. Your works are wonderful. The second area that I would like to say this morning is, and I hope I don't offend a lot of people this morning, but I guess I have to say what I need to say, is in the area of our Chinese New Year greetings and ang paos. In the area of our Chinese New Year greetings, in wishing one another a blessed Chinese New Year, I mean, ang paos or red packets containing money are given to children, parents, grandparents, and others. I think it's a good practice to show love and filial piety. The giving of ang pao is acceptable as long as we understand them as gestures of love and appreciation. So we do that, why? As a gesture of love and appreciation, rather than as symbols of unhealthy preoccupation with wealth. Why do we teach our children, when they receive the ang pao, they don't open it in front of us, do they? It's considered what? Rude. Why is it considered rude? Because it takes away the focus. Why are we giving the red packet? We are giving the red packet as a gesture of what? Love and appreciation. So the amount that is given, it's immaterial. However, some children have thought about it as, you know, when receiving ang pao, this is the time, you know, that they get a lot of money. Some of them, they think, this is the time for me to get rich. And so the ang pao becomes that symbol. It gives them an unhealthy preoccupation with wealth, which should not be the case. You know, for a matter of fact, the color red shouldn't have really any, you know, for us as Christians, color red shouldn't have just, I mean, we shouldn't like have our preference or whatever. It should be indifferent for us as Christians. Now, I'm not saying that we don't dress according to the occasion. I mean, you don't go to a funeral and you wear red, that would be disrespectful. But we need to understand that we wear red to celebrate. We rare wait because it's Chinese New Year, and you know, and it is something that we, you know, we wear out of, not because when we wear red, somehow it attracts good luck. Yeah, you know, I have friends, that during Chinese New Year, in order to test their luck for the coming year, what they will do is to go and gamble. So what would they do? They will arm themselves from head to the toe with all the good luck that they can get. Wear red, red shirt, red pants, red underwear. We all laugh, huh? Yeah, why? Because when I go and gamble, I need all the luck possible because I want to win. I want to get as much money. Unhealthy preoccupation with wealth, with money. How about the way that we greet one another? Oh, I think I'm going to touch. How do we greet one another for the Chinese New Year? Huh? How should we greet one another? 新年快乐. What does 新年快乐 means? Happy New Year. How about 恭喜发财? Oh, yo! By the way, I look it up. I look it up in the on Uncle Google. 恭喜发财 means congratulations for getting lucky or rich. 发财, you know, 发财, they say, become rich and become lucky. Now, again, please don't get me wrong. Pastor, why are you preaching? Are we against being rich? No. At the end of the service, what I always pray for you, what do I always pray for the people? I bless you as you go out, right? As the priest of the house, I bless you. And what is my prayer? May the Lord bless you and keep you. And then I go on to say, may the Lord prosper you even as your soul prospers. Well, I do acknowledge that money is important, but more importantly, it's our soul. So how do we greet one another? It's important. I would rather say, you know, hey, and please forgive me also because I sometimes make mistakes and I got to correct myself also. I would say, hey, a blessed Chinese New Year. Wishing you a blessed Chinese New Year. I try to avoid any appearance of, you know, by any chance people should misinterpret me that I am all talking about money. We have to be careful that we don't have this covetous spirit. The Bible tells us in 1 Timothy verse 6, chapter 6, verse 6, it says, but godliness with contentment is great gain. Let me read it to you again. 1 Timothy 6, verse 6, but godliness with contentment is great gain. For we brought nothing into the world, and we take nothing out of it. But if we have food and clothing, we will be content with that. Those who want to get rich fall into temptation and a trap, into many foolish and into many foolish and harmful desires that plunge people into ruin and destruction. For the love of money is the root of all kinds of evil. Some people, eager for money, have wandered from the faith and pierced themselves with many griefs. We have to be careful that we need to understand that while money is good, the Bible makes it very clear, the love for money is the root of all evil. There must be a place where we are content. Now, being content doesn't mean being laid back. Listen to me. Being content doesn't mean being laid back. I think if we strive for excellence, if we say that the Bible teaches us that we are to have accountability and to have an excellent spirit, then, friends, it is not being about being laid back. It's about giving your best, doing your best, but not recognizing that God, it is God who gives us the increase. And if He has given us for this, our portion, for this time, at this point, at this moment, we should be thankful and we should be content. Deuteronomy 8 verse 18. This one you must turn with me, everybody. 8 verse 18. Oh, by the way, I'll come to it. Deuteronomy 8, verse 18. What does he say? Come on, help me, church. But remember the Lord. Everybody, come on. But remember the Lord, for it is who gives you the ability to produce wealth. And so confirms His covenant, which He swore to your ancestors, as it is today. Who is the one who gave us the ability? Hey, by the way, Deuteronomy 8, verse 18, no, fat. Yad, fat, you know. And please, friends, I'm... It's kind of cynical. It's kind of ironic lah for me when I Deuteronomy Fat Yad Fat says this. Remember the Lord your God. It is what? You talk about wealth, it is He who gives you the ability. Oh, by the way, I don't believe in all these numbers thing on. I don't. Yeah, there's such significance in the Bible, you know, about 10, you know, about 12, about 7, and so on. But you know what? I don't go and look at the Bible and read the Bible and trying to look for all these symbols. That should not be the way we read the Bible. Amen? Still love me? Last one. Oh, this one, last one, I tell you, really. The tossing of Yisang. The tossing of Yisang and Chinese New Year decor, CNY decor. Now, concerning the eating of Yisang, which is a symbol of prosperity, I want to say it's not wrong to ask the Lord for spiritual and financial prosperity and well-being and so on. Again, we must not be unduly concerned about material wealth and success. Okay? We have to be careful when we are in the midst of tossing the Yisang. Some of us have this idea, the higher we toss the Yisang, the better. Higher. Higher, higher. Why higher? Oh, like stock market. And somehow in our belief, it's crept into our belief system. And then, you know, when we toss the Yisang, we must toss it in such a way that it overflows, fall onto the table. Am I correct or not? Don't nod your head. Yeah, we toss, because why? We want everything overflowing, in abundance, high, high. But remember the Lord, your God. It is He who gave you the ability to create wealth. Some of the Chinese decors that we see in our house, we have somehow. Now, I know we all like the color red. It's fine, decorated with red and all these things. But don't put Don't put your faith in it. Don't put your trust in it. Don't put... You know, some people must go and buy pineapple for Chinese New Year. Even though they don't, you know, pray or whatever, but they say, you know, in the house, good lah, must have a pineapple. Why pineapple? The Chinese word for pineapple is ong lai. Ong lai, no? In Chinese, you must eat pineapple, so ong lai. Ong lai means luck come. And somehow we buy into all these things as Christians. Oh, we put the word prosperity in our house, we put it upside down. We paste it on our doors. Think about it, church. Matthew 6, verse 24 says this. No one can serve two masters. Either you hate the other and love the other, or you will be devoted to the one and despise the other. You cannot serve both. Everybody here? God and money. You know what? This was the first thing that God had to deal with me when I came back to Him. Do you know that? Remember I told you how I only got grade 3 from my SPM? When I came back to the Lord told me, will you trust me, Gideon, for your future? I said, yes, I will trust you, God. It doesn't matter how my future turned out, whether I'm rich or whether I'm poor. God, I trust you. And He tested me in many ways. I remember one time, I was meeting up with my subordinate from my workplace. I already resigned in Bible school. So my subordinate was under me. Now he had taken over my place in the company. You know what? He wanted to blanja me lunch. And so he says, you know, he still calls me boss until today. He says, boss, you know, come, let's go out for lunch. I want to buy you lunch. I say, okay, you know, I decided to meet up with him. So I went out with him. And, you know, as I was sitting in that restaurant waiting for him to come, and by the way, we had banana leaf. And, you know, Indian restaurants, right, you can see the street on Main Street. I was sitting there waiting for him to come. I see my subordinate driving to the meeting, to our lunch meeting in a Mercedes. At that moment, the devil whispered to me, that could have been you in that Mercedes. This morning, friends, Mercedes or no Mercedes, can I say this to you? God has kept His word to me. I have neither lack. I have no lack. Look at me. Any lack? In fact, I think got some excess. After Chinese New Year, I need to go to the gym. No lah, no need to go to the gym lah. Just work a little bit harder. Hiking, yeah. I want to say this to you, church. When you learn how to trust in Him, all these things doesn't matter. I'm going to close. And everybody say it. How then should a Christian Chinese or Christian celebrate the Chinese New Year? Let me give you at least 5 areas how we should do it. How I think we should do it. Number one, be thankful. In this area, during Chinese New Year, be thankful. Chinese New Year, like every other event that God has given to earth, birthdays, anniversaries, are a good time for us to pause and to reflect on the goodness of God. And when we reflect on the goodness of God, we can't help but to say, God, thank you. Thank you. Second area, how should we celebrate the Chinese New Year? By honoring our parents. Woo. Honoring our parents. The Bible says in the Ten Commandments, honor your father and your mother. Because this is the first what? That comes with a promise. So we start the Chinese year, you know, we honor our parents. Now, I'm not saying that we bow before the ancestral tablet or anything like that. That's not honoring. I think while our parents are still alive, this is a good time during the Chinese New Year to honor our parents. Have we honored our parents this Chinese New Year? If they're still around, our older generation? Third area, how should the Christian Chinese celebrate Chinese New Year? By building relationships. Building relationships. Chinese New Year is a good time for reconnecting with relatives and friends, isn't it? God has instructed us to love our neighbors. So let us use this time to express our love for the people in our lives. Oh, that also means that we also prayerfully use this occasion to seek forgiveness and healing. You know, there are some relatives that you have some kind of misunderstanding with. Maybe Chinese New Year is a good time for you to seek forgiveness. It's a good time for us to build relationships. The fourth area, let our celebration be God-honoring. Chinese New Year, we are reminded that it is God who blesses us with our wealth. Chinese New Year is also a good time for us to give and to honor the Lord. Last but not least, and Gerald has said this a lot in the beginning of this service, how can we as a Christian Chinese celebrate the Chinese New Year? By being a witness. By being a witness. It's the Chinese New Year is a good time for sharing God's love with our loved ones, relatives and friends. And some of them, I must say for myself, I only see them once a year. I only see them once a year. So some relatives, I don't even know they were my relatives sometimes. I had to try to recall who they are. But it is a good time that on this special occasion, we pray for opportunities to share Christ with those whom we meet. So five areas that we can be a blessing this Chinese year. Number one, be thankful. Number two, honor your parents. Number three, build relationships. Number four, let it be God-honoring. And last but never least, be a witness. Oh, coming back. So how? Can we use the ang bao packets with the dragon on it or not? Let's be honest. The dragon has no hold on us. If you give me an ang bao packet with a dragon on it, I'll take it. I'll say thank you. I'll take the money out. And I throw away the ang bao packet. But can I say this? I'm not talking about receiving. I'm talking about you giving one. So we come back to the principles that I've shared before. What is the principles that I've shared before concerning this area? That everything may be legal, but not everything is being what? Beneficial. So first things first, we use this litmus test, first thing first, it must be God honoring. Remember? I said, in everything that we do, let us honor and glorify God. Second thing, what do we say? What did I say? Don't cause others to stumble. Right? For the sake of our weaker brethren, so for the sake of them, you may be strong spiritually, you have maybe have no issue, but some people may have, but for their sake. And then we always say this, the third one, do seek the good of others. We always seek the good of others. So we do everything in the glory of God. We do everything for the glory of God. So in these things, we ask ourselves, does this glorify God? Second thing, we ask ourselves, we don't want to cause anyone to stumble. And last but not least, we think about others. And then we do all this. The Bible tells us, remember, we do all this with the hope that what? Forgot already, yeah? That all may be saved. Remember? We're doing all this. Why? Why are we doing all this? That all may be saved. We want to be a good witness. We want to be God-honoring. We don't want to stumble others. We do all this so that everyone can come to the knowledge of His Son, Jesus Christ. The good news that He died for us and that today we don't have to die in our sins. Amen? Amen? So you ready for your Chinese New Year? So where we have fallen short, adjust, realign. Where we think we have not done well enough, let's adjust. No condemnation here. Adjust, realign, and let's continue to give God the glory. Can I get the musicians to come? Can we all just stand to our feet, even as we worship God in our last song? And let me just dismiss you with a blessing. Friends, I'm also very aware that sometimes during celebrations like this, not everyone is happy. Not everyone is joyful. Not everyone is approaching this celebration with maybe we are struggling with a sickness. And maybe even this Chinese New Year, we are missing a loved one. I know it's hard for some of us. It may not all be celebrations for all of us. So I want to encourage you as brothers and sisters, as sons and daughters, let's be mindful and about the people that are in our midst. That as we celebrate, remember there are people that are also hurting. There are also people who may feel that this may not be a time of celebration. So let us be sensitive towards them. Let us be gracious towards them. Let us be loving towards them. Amen. Let's sing this song. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. When the oceans rise and thunders roar, I will soar with you above the storm. Father, you are king over the flood. I will be still and know you, my God. I will be still and know you, my God. Hallelujah, hallelujah. So may the Lord bless you, and may the Lord keep you. May the Lord cause His face to shine upon you and give you rest. May the Lord your God prosper the work of your hands and cause you in every way to prosper, even as your soul prospers this morning. Know that He is the Lord your God, and He is the one who gives us the ability to make wealth. So Father, this morning, as your servant, I bless the people of God. May they go in the peace and the power and anointing of your Holy Spirit. I ask all this in Jesus' most precious name. And all God's people say, come on, all God's people say, why don't we give God a big hand this morning? God bless you. Thank you for coming. May you have a wonderful afternoon with your relatives and your loved ones. May the Lord watch over you and protect you. Have a wonderful day.